begged me to take the reins in his and Clara's stead. He wanted what was best for those birds. As did I. So I took him up on the offer and bought him out. And since then, I ain't seen either one of your parents. It was only after that I heard about Corneo's antics through the grapevine. Couldn't do a thing to stop him. Not with Shinra in the wings, that's for sure.
They say anything about me? Or my sister?
Not to me, no. Don't go thinking they forgot about you. You and your sister were always at the forefront of their minds. The business might have gone south, but they chose to give up their future to make sure you two could have yours. That's why you got a roof over your head, a place to work, and food to eat.
I can't believe it. I've had it wrong this whole time.
Son, I'd be surprised if there's a wild chocobo out there that doesn't owe its freedom to your mom and your dad, one way or another. Hell of a legacy to live up to, but if you want it, the business is yours. Just know this, it ain't gonna turn a profit. So unless you can find a way to fund it, you'll wind up in the same trouble as your folks. Think it over. Maybe chat with Pawpaw too. Call it. Heads or tails, son. Get it right, and I'll float you some operating capital.
Thanks, but no thanks. I'm gonna do this on my own. Me and Chloe and Gramps, I mean.
You truly are their boy. Got your old man's pig head and your mother's backbone. Not bad.
I'm gonna do my parents proud. You'll see. It may take some time, but I'll make sure their legacy lives on. I don't get it. If Gramps knew all this, why'd he make it sound like Sam was to blame?
He was probably trying to protect you, to stop you from going after Corneo or Shinra on your own. So he pinned it on Sam, knowing that your uncle would be okay shouldering the blame.
Shouldn't have to tell you this, but seeking revenge would be stupid.
I know. Still, if an opportunity did happen to come along, you'd help me out, wouldn't you?
Hey, I'm a world-famous jockey now. Can't be associated with that kind of stuff.
You had me going there. To brush up on my knowledge of wild chocobos.
Attention, chocobos!
Your trusty guide, Boogle, is at your service! Let's make friends, chocobo! And here we are!
I am the Dread of Babylon, the person responsible for Queen's Blood. that letter.
Letter? What letter?
You remember, don't you? The inn at Calm? I hung it on your door, though I signed it in the proprietor's name.
So that was you?
Forgive my subterfuge, but I was in dire need of a skilled player. And you certainly did not disappoint. You were even able to best me. Which, while impressive, won't be enough. Not if you intend to hold the Shadowblood Queen's card in your deck. That foul thing is the source of this nightmare. The very embodiment of the villain herself. Through the card, she feeds all wielders' life force, claiming their strength, that she may one day be reborn. Countless players have succumbed to this vile curse. And now one more death is all she requires to return. Cloud, find the sorceress. She who rallied the people. She who deposed the queen, the Emerald Witch. Her card sleeps in Nibelheim with a monster of chaos. You must hurry before it is too late.
Congratulations, Cloud. You have attained the rank of Blood Sovereign. This is it. Only one opponent remains. The Monster of Chaos. I know nothing of their skills, but I have faith that yours are superior. Vanquish this fiend and the witch's card will be yours.
And here.
This helicopter is bound for Costa...
Here.
You and yours.
Greetings, recruit. Here to exchange points.
Ranger.
Attack! Yourself a medal.